My theme this week is the Great Resignation, and I've been interviewing people all over the country who have resigned or about to resign or who are considering resigning to try and understand what's going on. And my working hypothesis when I went into this was that it's about change and finding something new in the aftermath of COVID. But I'm revising that view. Every time I'm doing this interview, this letter that I read a really long time ago keeps echoing through my mind. And it's a letter that a man called Chaim Herman wrote in Auschwitz towards the end of the war. And he was one of a small team who was selected to work in and around the gas chambers. He was Jewish. And as the Allies closed in, he realized that the Nazis would never let people like him live because they knew so much. So he wrote a letter to his wife and his daughter, and in it he said something like, "I'm sorry if there were trivial misunderstandings between us. I did not know how to value the passing time." And what I think COVID has given people is the opportunity to value their passing time, to think about what they do and its value to them, to the community and world around them, to their team, to their boss, to their organisation. McKinsey has just put out a report that says that there is a mismatch in expectations of what is important between employees and employers. And the things that employees think are important that employers are most likely to underestimate is that they are valued to their team and their organisation. And so if you're an organisation or a leader that's looking at enormous amounts of churn or worried about churn, I would say think about value. Think about how people value their time. Think about how they are valued by you and their organisation, and look at how they're treated. Because what comes through in interviews is that treatment, engagement, interactions before that people would have tolerated, they are no longer willing to tolerate. Now, I know that's not as cheerful as what I normally say on a Friday, and I don't have the dog to distract you because I'm here in beautiful, beautiful Aberystwyth in Wales doing research. So I have nothing else to give you other than the amazing view and the wild swimmers, and I look forward to seeing you next Friday.